at California Speedway. It's an old-fashioned Western shootout. The NASCAR Grand National Division West Series takes on its biggest track of the season. Nextel Cup veteran Ken Schrader won at Phoenix in this series earlier in the year. He'll be tough to beat. David Gilliland won the season's second race at Mesa Marin. He loved to make it two wins in a row. It's a mix of wily veterans and young guns. We'll find out how the West is won in California. Welcome to Racing in California. It's NASCAR's Grand National West Series, racing today at the 2 Mile California Speedway. It's a competitive field and we're expecting a great race. Hi everybody, I'm Mike Hogwood. Welcome to California. Pat Patterson is here alongside. Pat, this the largest track these guys are going to race on all year long.
Yeah, Mike, this is their Daytona 500. When they get to the California Speedway, they've really got their work cut out for them. 2 miles, and you would immediately think it's got to be thunder under the hood that makes the difference. Well, you got to have a good motor here, but you really have to handle. Two very different ends of the racetrack requires that a driver and crew chief really get their setup right. We'll talk about that more today, but a unique race and a big one for these guys.
Yeah, and a lot of great drivers in the field. Now let's bring in the third member of our broadcast team, Candace Krueger.
That's right, guys. I'm here in pit road. All the drivers are getting seated. We're moments away from the beginning of this race. Now, Austin, you've had your string of bad luck this weekend. Didn't do as well as you hoped in qualifying. Missed the meeting this morning. You're going to have to go back to the back. How are you feeling?
We're feeling good about this Napa Chevrolet. I tell you what, the guys did a heck of a job. We changed everything. So we're going to have a brand new car underneath us. And our goal is to go to the front.
Okay, well, best of luck to you, Austin. We'll be looking for you.
We'll be back and introduce the starting field to you and go racing from California Speedway coming up. Welcome back to a beautiful day here in Southern California. It's the King Taco 200. Man, I know you spend a lot of time out in this part of the country. Boy, the weather is absolutely gorgeous. Picture-perfect day today.
It really is. It's going to be hot by this afternoon. Fortunately, we're starting this race in the morning. Track temperature's good. We had Nextel Cup cars practicing earlier, put some rubber down on the racetrack, more rubber. We have not had any rain this week, so the track's ready. It's in good shape. So it means that these guys should be able to get at it real quick.
Expecting a high today in the low 90s. Well, now we'll tell you about the starting grid. And on the pole on the front row, Clint Bowyer, who said he drives some for Richard Childress. Kevin Conway alongside him in a car that is owned by Ernie Irvin. And then on row two, it's David Gilliland, who won the last race in this series at Mesa Marin. And the defending series champion, Scott Lynch, who's also going to have to drop to the back. He made an engine change.
Yeah, starting inside row number three, it'll be Johnny Borneman out of Ramon, California. And the veteran, Ken Schrader, Fenton, Missouri, he'll start outside row three. Eric Norris, a former winner in this race, goes off in the seventh spot. And Jose Luis Ramirez, racing his first time at California Speedway, he'll start on the outside of the row with Norris as well. That'll be row number four. Then it's Mike Duncan and one of the rookies, Nick DeFazio.
Yeah, or Duncan second in the points. DeFazio also off to a good start this season. Then J.R. Patton, Mike David, who has had a pretty good year as well, on row six. Now we move to row seven, and a guy from the Northwest Elite Series. I think you ought to watch out for the 25 car.
Hey, Jason Jefferson will be good today. Scott Gaylord out of Lakewood, Colorado, a very, very good racer. Timmy Woods, the third, rolls off in the 15th spot out of Chino Hills, California. This is his backyard, and Timmy's crew chiefed by a guy, Steve Portengay, who's won here at this racetrack, so that should be a good story. And Sean Woodside, unfortunately, is going to have to go to the back of the field. He had wrecked a car, had to bring up a backup car, so Woodside, a series champion and a veteran of this series for many, many years, will start in the back.
And Austin Cameron also going to the back. He's on row nine along with Brett Thompson. Row 10, David Eshelman, former mayor of the city of Fontana. And Nick Janitis is also there on row number two.
Darrell Hare will start, or Haar rather, will start in the 21st spot. Jason Small will start on the outside of that row. Carl Haar, his father, will start on row in 23rd spot, excuse me. And Jack Sellers, in his last year, full year of racing, Sellers will start in the 24th spot.
Been around a long time. On row 13, the 25th position, Steve Schaefer. And Blake Mallory. Mallory racing his first race in the West Series. And on row 14, 27th starting spot goes to Gene Woods of Ontario, California. And Doug Ingram of Vancouver, British Columbia.
And Bobby Hillis there in, from Phoenix, Arizona, will start in the back. Let's take a look at some of our onboard cameras, and I'll tell you what, I'm looking forward to this. These are some great shots, Mike.
Yeah. Looking forward to being on board today. We're on board with Kenny Schrader, and he will start eighth. And you see Schrader looking awful relaxed inside that car.
And Kenny should be relaxed. He's been out practicing just a few minutes ago in his cup car. There's a look out the front of the Federated Auto Parts machine. Give some good shots there as we get ready to go.
And Austin Cameron also carrying one of our inboards today. Cameron's, of course, because he missed the driver's meeting, going to have to move back to the rear of the field. A tough break for Cameron, and you see now some of the cars going by him, and it's going to be patience the word for Austin Cameron today.
Yeah, everybody's got to kind of just kind of get those jitters out of the way. It's for a lot of these guys getting out and, you know, getting onto the big track for the first time of the day, get a little bit nervous there as we take a look at Sean Woodside there driving a car. It's got Jerry Springer all of it. I'm not so sure that this car is just going to jump up and insult somebody all of a sudden. You know what I'm saying?
But he's had a tough time. I mean, he has had a tough weekend here and had to go to a backup car after wrecking his primary. And they just got it ready at the shop and brought it over here today. Sean Woodside out of Saugus, California.
And just to give you a little bit of the story there, Woodside works in the entertainment business here and actually does sound and all sorts of stuff for lots of shows over in Hollywood. The Springer Show is one of the deals that that he works with over there, so that's the reason we've got that. He's got that on his car and promoting the Jerry Springer Show here.
And before we go green, I want to make a note that Brandon Miller actually had the second fastest time in qualifying, but wrecked his car in the happy hour and had to withdraw from the race.
Man, we're getting close to turning them loose here, Mike. I am excited. 2 miles here is something to watch, man, and we're going to see ourselves some great racing here, the King Taco 200.
Pace car is pulling down on pit road. They are bunched together, and how about it? About ready to drop that green flag as they bunch up. It'll be Clint Bowyer and Kevin Conway leading them to green. Bowyer gets a good jump. We're underway at California Speedway.
Takes these cars just a little bit of time to come up to speed, but certainly looks like Bowyer's got a good jump.
A Bowyer who has won in just about every series he's ever raced in. Gets a couple car length lead on the first lap, and I really think these guys know that patience will be the order of the day.
I think we may have a couple of cars that got a little anxious there. The 45 car and the 16 both have been notified by NASCAR that you jumped my start, and that's going to cost them some time.
Jason Small in the 45, and of course the 16, Austin Cameron. His day has not started out very good. On board with Ken Schrader right now. Schrader has moved up to the fifth position, started in eighth.
Yeah, Kenny knows right now, just comes off turn two, and we look down the backstretch here at California Speedway. The wind really isn't that big a factor. A little earlier, it was really blowing, and now it's just kind of died down. And the 16 car has come down to take his penalty for the for jumping the start. Austin Cameron on the pit road as we continue to watch through Schrader's car. They're now back taking a look at Kenny as he works back down towards the front stretch.
Yeah, the penalty for Austin Cameron, and he's going to have a tough time getting up to speed. He may be going a lap down here.
Well, there's no question, Mike, that the field's going to catch him real quick, and he will lose a lap for sure. And it was a pass-through penalty, so all he had to do was actually just come down the pit road. He didn't actually physically have to stop in his pit.
Bowyer catching up with Austin Cameron is going to go right by him on the back stretch. And Austin Cameron, early in this race on the second lap, goes a lap down as you see Bowyer going by him.
Reminder that the pit road speed today, when they do come down pit road, is 55 miles per hour. So crew chiefs and spotters will be reminding guys of that as they do have to come to the pit road. We do expect at least one major pit stop today in this race. Of course, other guys may pit as they get time.
Bad one to talk about. The guy has made the move up to second place, and it's Johnny Borneman in the eighth car. That Pontiac is flying. Borneman, 26 years old, has a couple of career wins.
Oh. Johnny is a good racer, tried to make the Busch race, actually going to race for Ed Rincey this weekend as a teammate to the 25 car of Bobby Hamilton Jr. They didn't make the show, unfortunately, but he's in good shape for this race as you're back up front there with the leader, Clint Bowyer.
We'll have more of the King Taco 200 from the California Speedway in a moment. Young Clint Bowyer. Boy, what a future he's got ahead of him.
His car is working really good, you know, right down to the bottom of the racetrack there. You saw him working around turns one and two. Mike, this place is really an oddity when it comes to getting a car set up. Three and four are so different from one and two, and you really are seeking a balance all day long out here in these cars, and you need some adjustability. This pit stop that they'll have later on for fuel will be critical as well for getting maybe dialing the car in a little bit more.
Well, we didn't talk a lot about that early in the broadcast, Pat. Let's talk about these pit stops in that you can't make it on fuel. The tire rule is that you allow 10 total tires, and that includes the four on the car. You have six in the pits, and so I would think that tires would make a difference, but you're only allowed to change two on a yellow stop.
Yeah, and basically they do that to control the cost of this series, even here on the speedways. In most short track races, they only get a couple tires. So, you know, for here, it was appropriate to have the number of tires that they do. Talking about the cars a little bit on the racetrack, you know, basically, you know, he got a lot of Bill Moropoulos' motors in quite a few of these cars, and he builds some good horsepower. The RPM you want to turn here is somewhere around 7,400 to 7,800. That's really where your power band's at on these engines, on these cars. Most of these guys are pulling like a 340 to 350 gear around the racetrack, which, like I say, for Clint Bowyer, that was an enormously fast qualifying lap that he had here.
I'll tell you what, Bornemann's done a good job of catching up with him. There you see the 08 car. That is Scott Lynch. Lynch changed the motor and had a drop to the rear. He is the defending series champion.
There may be a problem on the 20 car, as he certainly has lost a lot of steam. And Clint and Bornemann, rather, is about to close up on him and maybe a pass for the lead.
Well, Bornemann looks like on the back stretch. You're right, he has really closed the gap, but I'll tell you what, Bornemann and Bowyer have put tremendous distance between themselves and the rest of this field. And Bowyer seems to be hanging pretty tough right now, though.
Some of what may be going on, Mike, is Clint Bowyer's crew chief may have just said, look, you need to slow down just a little bit here. You don't want to set such a pace that we wear these tires out so fast you got nothing to race with. Now these two cars are hooked up together, so we'll see if he's got a problem or he just wanted some help.
Well, Johnny Bornemann, if you followed this West Series, you know that last name's pretty famous. His dad raced in this series as well. We are nine laps in. We'll race 100 here.
Wow, what beautiful pictures and an absolutely gorgeous day. Back on board with Kenny Schrader as he has got a beat on David Gilliland.
And Schrader has made his way past Conway. He's in the fourth position now. So he's steadily gaining on the field and has set his sights, as you said, on young David Gilliland, who's straight ahead of him. Gilliland's had quite a start to this season. The win at Mesa Marin.
Well, his father, Butch Gilliland, was a longtime competitor out here and just a really, really nice guy. It's a family affair with those guys. I had a chance through my relationship over at Irwindale Speedway to you know, kind of be around for Gillen, to watch him develop as a driver. And truly, David is I think he's even better than his dad. I think his dad would tell you that as well. But he's doing a great job out here, and right now he's got a good spot out there on the racetrack doing good work today.
Well, one thing I think we can agree on is that there's not a lot of trouble on Bowyer, but there is trouble on the racetrack, and we have a caution flag. Caution is out on lap number 11. Bowyer takes the yellow flag, Bornemann right behind him. And there looks like a car has hit the wall in turn two.
They were trying to get
the number four car of Nick Giannitis. Yeah, as you can see, there's some fire under the hood.
And he's out of the car. You just saw Nick come up to the wall, sit down up there. He obviously is shaken. And that's some oil fire, some of the oil coming out of the front of the car that they're trying to get those flames extinguished as quickly as possible. Emergency crews quickly on the scene. Man, I'm glad to see how fast they got there. And you can see them tending to Nick Giannitis up there. He's sitting by the wall where the emergency workers are working now.
This is Nick Giannitis' first West race. He's been a regular on the Southwest Tour in the Elite Series. Well, we're under caution for the first time. 11 laps in to the King Taco 200. Clint Bowyer is your leader. LA. Crash in turn two. Nick Giannitis lost control of that Chevrolet and obviously he's out for the day, and you see him up against the wall. The safety workers are tending to him, and you're right, Pat Patterson, they got there very, very quickly.
Yeah, that was a pretty good hit that he took up there, you can see, and we've got ourselves a pretty big mess as we see pit road will be open this time by. Actually, they're going to bring all the cars down pit road behind the caution car so that they can clean the mess up out on the racetrack.
And Bowyer and Bornemann and company all coming down pit road. Not normally the pit road speed would be 55 miles an hour. Here, much slower than that.
Yeah, and I'm curious. I mean, if we're going to get a red flag, are we going to stop the race? Is that what we're doing? Yes, we are going to get a red flag. So, obviously, the yellow flag was still flying. We were looking at that, trying to figure out, well, are they going to put the red flag out or not? But, obviously, they're bringing all the cars down the pit lane. And, actually, I'm going to see if I can get a word with Kenny Schrader. Kenny Schrader, this is Pat Patterson up in the booth. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I got you, Pat.
How about your race so far, bud? Looks like you got off to a pretty good start there. Obviously, we're going to stop here, but how's your car?
Well, I'd like it to be a little freer in, a little tighter off, but hopefully we'll get a yellow flag here and be able to do a little adjustment on it, but got to get it a little bit better, Pat.
All right, partner, we'll check in with you later on as soon as we get this cleaned up and get back going again. So
right.
Ken Schrader, obviously talking about his race cars. We watch the cars being parked out here, Mike, and again, got a lot of cleanup to do out there in turn number one.
Well, let's hope again Nick Giannitis is okay. I want to welcome into the booth right now a guy who did quite well in this series and on this racetrack, Brendan Gaughan, former champion in the West Series and who is now in the Nextel Cup. And he's running great here. He qualified fourth. Brendan, great to see you. Good to have you here. Well, great.
Pretty happy about that. You know, it's a first run here in the Nextel Cup car, but this is where we had many, many great runs against quite a few Cup drivers. Kenny Schrader and Johnny Benson used to teach me a lot of lessons here in the old Winston West days. So track near and dear to my heart, and got my Winston West team out there, and my old West team, Bill McAnally, and those guys. So still love this series a lot. It's a great series to race.
Yeah. Looks like they're out, going to be checking that track out right now. And real important for these guys, Brendan, isn't it, that they get a good, clean racetrack on the restart and that the drivers actually go out and check this track out, make sure everything's been cleaned up.
Well, yeah, you always want to – that's one of the big things mentally as a race car driver people don't understand is that this is a very mental game. And you go out there, somebody just had an accident, you know, the stuff on the racetrack, you get a little nervous. You cut a tire. I mean, you're doing 200 mile an hour. You cut a tire, you know what's going to hurt. So – you want to be able to go around the racetrack, take a quick peek at it, make sure there's nothing out there that's going to spook you. You know, I qualified here a couple years ago when my old teammate Herschel McGriff, he had blown a motor in turn three, and I was the next guy to qualify. So they sent us out there, a quickie dry down there. They said, the track's clear. I hit that speedy dry and scared the heck out of myself, and I'll never forget that. I went, oh, you know, you always want to be able to look at the racetrack before you get there. This gives them a nice shot to just warm up and get themselves that peace of mind.
Well, one of the neat things that's going to go on here in just a minute is under caution, we're going to be able to pit the cars. I mean, the guys that want to come in and take two tires and come in and get some adjusting done on their race car are going to be able to do that for the first time under caution as opposed to having to make that first green flag pit stop. Man, this place, like all super speedways, it takes time and experience to get on and off this pit road.
Absolutely. I'm still not good at it.
Well, it's been a tough day so far for one Austin Cameron, who we said missed this race last year, and there's Austin. He's now being posted in the 27th position, one lap down. Missed the driver's meeting, had a start at the rear, jumped the start, got a pass-through penalty, and that put him the lap down, and he's going to be fighting uphill a long time today.
Yeah, but I got to tell you something. Sometimes, as hard as this is to believe, and Brendan will back me up on this, sometimes when things look like they just won't go your way at all, you end up pulling a rabbit out of your hat. Now, it doesn't happen every time, but some days when everything just looks so bad, it can actually turn around on you.
And Austin Cameron and that BMR crew, they're fighters out there. And the nice thing now is you got that lucky dog thing. All Austin has to do is get a couple spots up here, gain a few positions, so, you know, next caution that comes out, You have the lucky dog in the series? No, there's no lucky dog in the series. I'm getting NASCAR telling me, no lucky dog in the Grand National. Oops.
That's
well,
good,
then guess what? He's got his work cut out for him. He's got to race his way back there the old-fashioned way. So
yeah.
He's definitely got to start digging. Now, he'll start on the double file up near the front.
Yeah.
If he's got a good race car, he'll move up there.
Pits are open. We'll see if anybody. We heard Ken Schrader say he needed an adjustment on the car.
We'll watch and see if we're going to get the leaders. If Boyer, I think, is going to stay out, which means I think everybody else is going to stay out except for guys that have got to have something done.
Austin Cameron coming in. That's a good move. Why not? Put two tires on him. I mean, he's, you know, he's that one lap down. He can come in, put two tires, get some fresh ones, try to race him.
So Austin Cameron will come to the attention of his crew. Also, Bobby Hillis is on pit road. A number of others coming down the pit lane.
Brett Thompson. Jason Small, my buddy old Jason Smallsy out there.
Yep.
Good move for these guys in the back. You know, Scott Lynch, there's our car. I mean, smart move. You're in the back.
You might as well.
You know, might as well come and take two tires, get it full of fuel. Looks like the Orleans team, they're actually just doing fuel only. A lot of guys, Brett Thompson, fuel only.
Zero-eight car, same thing.
Pull a piece of tape, probably getting a little hot. It's a good move. You can run a little bit longer now, and a lot of guys in the back, it's a smart move on their place.
Well, Brent, the track position is going to be important, and if you top off now with fuel, you may not need another stop.
You know, looking at this, it's a 100-lap race, 87 laps.
Still going to have to stop.
You're still going to have to stop. You know, I don't think we can do, even with the 390 carburetor, I don't think they can make it 87 laps. But it does give you a nice spot where, as guy, you catch a lap, you catch that brake you're talking about.
Yep.
Green flag pit stop, caution comes out, you put yourself in a great position.
I don't think I'd want to run 87 laps without a couple more tires either, would you?
These are Bias Fly Goodyear tires out there today, and I would not be very happy at lap about 80 on this tire.
Yeah, that's a little much, I think.
Not that it's a bad tire, but oh no.
No, it's good
tire. Bias Fly rubber out there about lap 50 is going to hurt.
It looks like they're actually taking a look at a couple of the tires, just checking basically to.
That's a
brand
sticker
new
right
tire.
There. They're getting ready. What crew? That looks like the BMR crew down there getting ready to possibly stick one on there.
And guys, I think we got great news here. We're going to get the one to go this time by. So we are about ready to get this race back underway. We're back on speed as we return to California Speed.
Side by side as they cross the line. Austin, Clint definitely isn't going to give it to him going into turn one.
No, Austin Cameron, though, he is really digging hard. You know, this is a big moment for him, and he is side by side now with Boyer.
Almost clear. Got him.
Well,
he's going to race for it.
Well, at the tail end of the lead lap now is Austin Cameron.
I'm impressed with how Bornemann stayed with him on the restart right there, aren't you, Brendan? I mean, without the clutch. He was rolling pretty good.
Remember, on restarts here, we don't use the clutch much. We got Jericho Boxes just shifted right into gear, and Bornemann, they've been around a long time there. He's going up for a position underneath. He's looking underneath Clint there.
We were talking about Austin Cameron a moment ago, and how about Bornemann?
There he goes.
Bornemann battling for the lead, and he is side-by-side for the lead with Clint Boyer. And, you know, I think that Austin Cameron, because he got penalized for jumping the start of the race, really was careful on that restart, did not want to get penalized once again.
Wow, look at Bornemann. He stuck right on the bottom there. He is flying right now. He doesn't want Austin to get back on that lap. He knows it's a tough car to beat, and if he can keep him down that lap, he's going to try.
Well, and I can't believe that Boyer gave that spot to either one of those two guys. I mean, you can't shut a door as fast as you can open one here. There's no question about that, but I don't believe he just gave him that spot.
And Bornemann.
Here they come two out of turn three.
I thought he just told you he was going to wait. No, not waiting for Johnny Bornemann now.
You find out real fast in super speedway racing, there is no plan. The only plan is what you see in front of you right then, right now, you know?
Things change real quick in this business. Looks like Austin, he just doesn't have the race car to hold up there with Johnny and Clint. They're moving out there.
Ton, he's way up the racetrack too, man. That is not where you want to be, you know, at that point of that corner over there.
But Austin's a veteran. He did the right thing. You know, he cleared those guys, let them go a little bit. Talk about veterans. Here we go.
Yeah, there you go. Ken Schrader working on David Gilliland.
Schrader still running in the fourth position. Gilliland is running third. In the fifth spot, it's Kevin Conway, the Lynchburg, Virginia driver, in the car owned by Ernie Irvin. And there inside, you're on board now with Ken Schrader.
That man taught me a lot around this racetrack. He really did a good job helping me out around this place. Taught me a whole lot about racing.
He's won here twice, 1997 and 98. Five top fives here. Finished second in this race 1 year ago.
Talk a little bit, Brendan, about the wind. You know, we had a lot of breeze earlier this morning. It's basically gone kind of a dead calm out there right now. The wind can really become a major player here in terms of determining how well your car handles.
In Nextel Cup qualifying yesterday, the wind kicked up, and when the wind comes down and blows into turn two, it makes you get really tight coming off. Right now, dead wind conditions. You're looking at Borneman here. He can drive that thing down to the bottom. It doesn't get loose. It stays there. There's no air to pick that nose up. So he keeps it right where he wants to, drives it off the corner, and it makes it really nice and fun on this place when there's no wind, because there's no air. That whole aero factor of the wind gets taken out.
Boy, Johnny Borneman is really checked out from Clint Bowyer. Now some 7-8 car lengths as they head through turns one and two.
There's good paddles going on around the racetrack as well. It's not just up front where they've kind of strung out a little bit. The whole field is somewhat strung out there. As you get back to Ken Schrader again working on Gilliland, you can see it's the 16 car there fading off into the background. Austin's definitely got some problems on his race car, not up to speed, as you continue to watch Johnny Borneman pace the field.
He's moving away. His Ford looks pretty nice right there. I mean, you gotta give it to Cram and the guys. He looks pretty good, but Boyer's, he's not going anywhere too fast. He's making himself known that he's right there.
Well, I'm sorry, Mike, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead. If you're Clint Bowyer, too, and I mean, it's still real early in the race, and as long as you can keep that leader in your sights, you're going to be a little bit patient out there.
Well, remember, some guys stopped for fuel. Those two didn't right there, so maybe you want to pace yourself a little bit, sit in that draft. Anytime you sit in the draft, you're going to conserve some fuel, so might be a good strategy to save a few gallons of gas. Here we go. Looks like we got Scott Gaylord going for the pass against Jason Jeffson. Jeffson, Northwest Tour racer, great young kid.
Yeah, he is.
That is the battle for the eighth position. Jefferson, who is out of Washington State. And boy, has he had some big wins there. Here's a guy who won the first West Series race he ever entered, Tri-Cities.
Yep. Jefferson and Scott Gaylord, a lot of experience. I mean, that's a guy that's been around this place 100 times, so that's a tough competition for Jefferson.
Jason Jefferson in the 25. The double zero is Scott Gaylord. We'll have more of the King Taco 200 from the California Speedway in a moment. Welcome back to NASCAR's Grand National Division West Series here in Southern California. It's the King Taco 200.
You know, Kenny Schrader, you're watching the in-car here. Schrader, look at how smooth he is on that wheel. He drives in there just nice and easy. You know, that's a good handling race car right there. He's not doing a whole lot. Just those little bounces are how bouncy this track is a little bit. Smooths it on out. You got to like that.
You know, and it takes a veteran like that. You know, his car is not handling near as well as he wants it to today, yet he's been able to pass Gilliland, moved into the third position. And it takes a veteran to take kind of an ill-handling race car, a car that you're not happy with, and still get it to stay up front.
No, that's the trick. I mean, I was, you know, on last night with DW on Trackside Live, and Buddy Baker's one of my mentors, and he said, you know, you can always tell the sign of a great driver is the guy that takes a car that shouldn't win and can put it up near somewhere. And Kenny Schrader's always had that ability.
And I want to point out to everybody that we're basically nose to tail pretty much throughout this field, and pretty spread out. When I say nose to tail, I mean, in other words, we don't have a lot of battles going on around the racetrack right now. It's the reason we're kind of watching here through the front of Schrader's car. But we do look like all of a sudden, well, that's a lap car that we've got in between there for Schrader. But Schrader is closing in on the 20 car. He's gaining some ground.
You know, Schrader looks like the 20 maybe fading a little bit. You know, maybe he is getting tight. That you picked that out earlier, Pat, that he's running a little bit higher off the corner. And maybe he's getting a little tight, and Schrader looks like he's starting to reel him in.
But look, you see how low he was down in one and two, though? I mean, he's right there on the bottom of the racetrack there on that end of the track. So, again, illustrating how different the ends of this racetrack really are.
We are 34 laps now complete, working lap number 35. And Johnny Borneman there in that eight car as he puts Blake Mallory a lap down in the six.
Blake's a good kid. Raced against him a couple times. He tried to run a couple truck races last few years, and he's a good guy. Came from the World Outlaws and open wheel sprint car stuff. He's a good little driver.
There was a good shot just a minute ago where Schrader's gaining some ground. He's able to hold his car down at the bottom over there in three and four, and I think that's where he's gained some ground on the 20 car.
Well, I tell you what, I think a lot of these guys now need some kind of adjustment, and if we get any kind of a caution now in the next 10 laps with that tire rule, they would be able to put some fresh tires on with the allowed six tires in your pits. I think we're going to see some stops as this field is really strung out, and the top three have checked out from the rest of the field here in this race.
Here's where some strategy can come into play. If there's no caution, you know, you got to stop for fuel at least. You know, maybe one of these guys in the back, you know, the 61 Brett Thompson, Eric Norris, maybe they take a chance. They come in, they do it under green and hope that it, you know, it stays for a while. This is where you got to start gambling. This is the fun part about being a race car driver. I don't make those decisions. I let the crew chief do that and tell me when to go, and it's his fault.
Oh, you just come in after the fact and go, I can't believe that we didn't pit when that guy pitted, or wait a minute, da-da-da-da-da. You know, that's the way that always goes. By the way, 43 to 48 laps, about what a fuel run is. We're 36 laps in, so, I mean, even if you came in now and you filled up and short pitted or whatever, you're gonna be back. So you start betting on caution flags, and that's when you do not want the crew chief's job.
Exactly. That crew chief job, I don't envy Shane, my crew chief, and it's a tough business down that pit box. You know, I always thought it was tough in the you know, West Series. Now you go to the Nextel Cup, the pressure on these guys is enormous. I mean, making decisions right now when you go, it's tough to do in this business.
Well, let's start speculating a little bit about these pit stops that are going to be coming up somewhere probably within 10 laps from now. And remember, Johnny Borneman has said his pit stops are going to be tough, so he has to make a pit stop under green. It's going to be really tough for him.
It's going to hurt him. He needs got to see where Johnny Borneman's pit stall is, too. That's a big deal. It's right in front of us here at the start-finish line, so that doesn't hurt him. If he was down at the front, they couldn't push very far. So that at least he's got some room to push, but a green flag stop would hurt him.
Remember, he does not have a clutch in that car.
When you talk about pushing, he's talking about the crew actually physically having to push that car to get it restarted. And, again, talking about athletes, you ever pushed one of those cars with all that adrenaline going? It is it's something to see.
This
it really
is a team sport, gang. Everybody forgets this is a team sport. Those seven men that are going to go over the wall, they're going to get a workout today.
Oh, yeah.
3,300 pounds. There are now 18 cars on the lead lap here. Last car on the lead lap is Nick DeFazio, who is a local driver and running in as a rookie this year in the West Series.
Yeah, Nick, and just to talk about Nick for just a second, you know, he really just wanted to come out and get some laps. First Super Speedway race ever, and, of course, his dad runs the Irwindale Speedway over there, Bob DeFazio, and, man, I know he's just glad that he's out here running a good, clean heads-up race, wants to get a good finish today. That's the most important thing.
Irwindale Speedway, great speedway. If you guys haven't seen that place, Southern California area, it's just beautiful.
You've had a few fun days over there, haven't you?
Went a few times around that place. It's pretty nice. Look at Clint, though, back up on the bumper.
Yeah, and again, you just wonder a little bit, is Borneman's car, are they still down right at the bottom of the racetrack down there in the corner when they were coming around? So, I mean, cars are still working pretty good.
And remember, they have not stopped for fuel, and so coming up on that pit window, and they'll need to make a stop and in all probability take two tires as well.
Now, this is where earlier, guys, on that caution flag, we saw those guys in the back come in. This is where it becomes a big deal now, because Scott Lynch, Brent Thompson, some of those guys, they stopped at lap 12. You're saying 45 laps, that's 67. They can make it all the way to the end. Yep. So if it stays green, they have the advantage, those guys that put fuel in.
And Pat, I'll tell you what, they've got somebody from Brendan's crew here saying it's time to go, get him ready for practice in this race. So Brendan, we want to thank you for coming by and visiting with us. We'll have more NASCAR Grand National West Series racing on Speed when we come back.
Looks like Clint Boyer's closing up here, but be curious to see if this isn't about when Borneman's going to go ahead and bring it to the pit road. We'll see if these two guys come around the same time. They work down the back stretch, and again, 49 laps complete.
We will be halfway this time by here in the King Taco 200. Well, let's head down to the pit lane and Candace.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Johnny Borneman's crew chief, Kevin Cram. Now, Kevin, how are things going so far? We talked to you earlier, talked about the clutch problem. Give us an update.
Yeah, we're about to live that problem here. About lap 53, we're going to see what that's all about. So, car's going good. Looks like the 20 car is a little bit too tight behind us. I think if he got in front of us, he'd probably be gone, but can't get by us right now. A little too tight. So, we'll just play with it. Hope I can make it to lap 53 and deal with this clutch deal.
About to need to bring him in for some fuel, I guess.
What's that?
You're about to need to bring him in for some more fuel?
Yeah, lap 53.
Okay. Thank you, Kevin.
Okay, so there's the answer when Borneman's going to come in on lap 53, and I'm pretty sure he'll be taking some tires as well. And remember, without that clutch, getting off pit road is going to be a challenge. And I thought that was an interesting comment that Boyer, that they feel that if he got by, may just check out, but he's a little tight, not able to pass, and that's
Clint
been a
Boyer's
big
coming to, he's coming to pit road right now. Got to get that car wowed up to 55 miles an hour on the pit road to get down and get to the attention of his crew, and We'll see how this stop works out for him as he'll make his first stop.
Young driver who ran last year in the Midwest Elite Series, but he's moving up fast. Richard Childress Racing has him running some Busch Series races out of Emporia, Kansas. Sat on the pole here. He's been running second most of the day to Barneman and his crew going to work on the car.
He almost won the Busch Grand National race over in Nashville a couple of weeks ago. Has had just spectacular runs. You see that crew gets the work done very quickly there on the right side. Now moves over to the left for four tires.
And you see, those are some of the RCR guys. One of Kevin Harvick's crew members on the jacket. He is down and away. An excellent stop for Clint Bowyer, your pole sitter.
Nice to have friends, huh?
Yeah, indeed it is.
Scott Gaylord on the pit road there in the double zero.
You know, a number of these guys have got some of the Cup and Busch pit guys pitting for them today.
That's one of the big advantages of racing on a weekend when you've got all these other teams here. Some of these guys can go out and get some of that talent as you watch Gaylord pull away in his car.
Also now on pit
Jason
road.
Jefferson coming
Jason,
to pit road.
Jason Jefferson is on pit road.
Talked about him earlier out of the Northeast. This is one of the guys who's making some of his first super speedway pit stops. Looks like he got into the box well there. They'll get the right sides
and
changed on
Barneman,
his car.
Your leader is on pit road right now. And that will give the lead over to Ken Schrader, who has not made his stop yet. It's going to be interesting to see, without that clutch, what happens at the end of this stop. And it looks like the crew will change four tires as they have on most of these green flag stops. We have had a long green flag run here after an early caution.
Well, they'll all be ready to start pushing here as you're getting ready to see. Watch right here.
And only two tires.
Got to knock it out of gear and then push it and try to re-crank it again, hitting the starter at the same time, and they get it fired up. That was really good.
A great job by the crew and a great job by the driver, Johnny Barneman. Did not lose a lot of time
David
there on
Gilliland.
The pit lane.
There's and David Gilliland on the pit road.
So Ken Schrader is the only of the leaders, and Schrader is on pit road as well. Ken Schrader coming to the attention of his crew in the 99 car.
Saw that car, the 88 car, David Gilliland's absolutely one of the best paint jobs I've ever seen on a race car. You watch Schrader get his Federated Auto Parts machine into the box.
Well, his Pontiac is up on the jacks now, and they will change on the right side. Let's see if they'll go around and make a four-tire change for Ken Schrader.
They made a chassis adjustment there. I saw that. So,
and it is a four-tire change. You can see through the window the jackman jacking up the left side of that car. Four fresh tires on for Ken Schrader. Remember that Barneman only took two because of that clutch problem, and a good pit stop for Ken Schrader. And we'll have to see now here on lap 55 how this all sorts out after this round of pit stops. That during that early caution, Scott Lynch came in and took on fuel. He is now being posted as the leader, Pat.
But he can't go all the way, and that's all there is to it. There was a speeding penalty on the 25 car, so that is the reason he came back in. And I guess they go ahead and get some more service done if you got to come down on pit road.
But some of these guys now are a little bit out of sequence with the drivers who were leading this race, and that includes Scott Lynch, Mike Duncan in the 9 car, and Brett Thompson in the 61. They are your first three cars right now. And then it is back to Bowyer in the 20, Barneman, and Ken Schrader now being posted in the 6th position.
Yeah, Mike, that's what we were talking about earlier. You know, you can come in, you can take a chance, get tires and all that sort of stuff and get fuel, and it's going to allow you to stay out in front, you know, for a short period of time. But what obviously is going to happen is if we don't get a caution flag, the track position that you gain, you know, will go for naught because you're going to have to come back in, pit your car, get enough fuel to go the rest of the way, which Scott Lynch does not have that amount of fuel at this time.
But Lynch, who had to go to the rear after changing a motor in the car,
apparently the 25 car really having some frustrations there. They're going to have to bring him back in again. NASCAR assessing another penalty on the 25. So one of those learning sort of days for Mr. Jefferson today here out on the racetrack. And, hey, that's what it's all about. You got to come out here and get some experience, figure out how to get on and off the pit road and how to do it within the rules that NASCAR sets.
Well, Jason Jefferson ran three West races last year, had a win. And we remember, we told you, Scott Lynch pitted early, so he does have a little bit out of sequence now with everybody else, and so he's posted as the leader. And I think one of the interesting things to watch now, how much power does Clint Bowyer have with the fresh tires, full load of fuel? Can he get by Thompson, Duncan, and Lynch?
Well, the biggest thing, Mike, is just to get back out and get back to doing what you were doing. You know, get back to getting your rhythm again, find your spots on the racetrack, make sure your car is working as good or better, you know, in both ends of this racetrack, which we've talked a lot about here today. That's the important thing right now. It's not so much about trying to chase somebody down as much as it is about getting the best possible stopwatch time as you can each and every time you get around this racetrack.
Yeah, and they've just shown the black flag to Jason Jefferson to come in and get that additional penalty. He's already had one, as we said. Looks like Lynch might be slowing a little bit.
Yeah, he's going to come on in, I imagine, now and make his pit stop is what he should do as he cycles through. And, you know, he figures now he's within his pit window of going ahead, fueling up, and having enough fuel to go the rest of the way.
Oh, Scott Lynch on pit road. Lynch out of Burley, Idaho. Charlie Wilson is crew chief.
Ooh, man, he locked up his front brakes, too, as he slid into the box there. Looks like they're going to make a chassis adjustment on his car.
Scott Lynch, who won the championship a year ago as a rookie. Pretty tough to do. And you heard Brendan Gaughan say how much stock that they have in Scott Lynch, how much they think of him, and they think of his abilities as a driver. Graduated from the University of Utah with a communications degree. Four wins in the series, and Scott Lynch down and away.
That's a racing family there. He's got a brother that races and really does a great job as well. As watch the nine car now coming to the pit road as well. That is, of course, Mike Duncan.
Duncan, who had been running second. Duncan, who is second in points. 1 point behind Mike David after two races. Duncan Chevrolet. Bill Sedgwick, the chief on that car. Sedgwick with 17 wins in this series.
Talk about a veteran.
Yeah, quite a name. Mike Duncan finished second in the points last year, just 14 points behind Scott Lynch.
Only one caution flag, but a pretty clean race so far, Mike. Really has, and that was really a single car incident.
Absolutely. In this field, because of this long green, and you've talked about it, Pat, it's really strung out. Almost anywhere you look on this racetrack, you're going to see a car. And so we cycled back around now, and Bowyer, your pole sitter, is now posted as the leader.
I think everybody has made their pit stops at this point, so we should be back to where we were initially, with exception of Borneman and being behind Bowyer as opposed to in front of him. And a lot of that just may be all on the pits. You know, the fast pit stop that Bowyer had, and of course they had to push Johnny's car off because of the clutch problem that he had.
Borneman in the second position in the 99. There is Ken Schrader going for second place. Whatever changes they made on that machine must have really helped it, because Schrader now in second.
Just went around Johnny Borneman.
It'll be interesting to see if Schrader is ready to make a move or can make a move on Clint Bowyer. We'll have more of the King Taco 200 from the California Speedway in a moment. Conway a little bit. Lynchburg, Virginia driver, still in the top five, running fourth. And Scott Gaylord also has made his way into the top five, getting past David Gilliland.
Kevin Conway's done a great job here today. Of course, this is his first look at California Speedway. He was back east, I think it was last night, as a matter of fact, racing a midget car, USAC midget car that he races in. And looks like that the 16 car is that actually gotten back on the lead lap?
I was just inquiring about that a moment ago, but he is being posted now. Austin Cameron in the seventh position. And I believe Austin Cameron's going to be coming down on the pit lane now. He had made his way back on the lead lap, but he had a pit stop to make. And so Cameron now on pit road as we are still under green, and boy, was he hoping for a caution.
Yeah, and they really need to get on and off pit road in a hurry. This is going to be a big deal here to lose as little time as possible. And you can see that car is really heated up. You can see the steam coming out the right side overflow there. He's really gotten that car hot. So they're going to change two tires there, and hopefully, and they're making a pretty massive look like chassis adjustment there as well for Austin Cameron.
Four tires stop. As it jacks up on the left side, tires are going in, and boy, pretty long time on pit road right here for Austin Cameron.
Yeah, you don't see the 14-second, 13-9 seconds pit stops to do in the Nextel Cup Series. We talked a little bit about that, but good stop for him, and he's got all the service he needs to go to the end of this race.
So Cameron's good to go, but will now drop back one lap down.
Taking a look again at Austin Cameron as he brings his car to the attention of his crew on the pit lane. Kind of locks up that front brake. Didn't get over the air hose. That's good. And the car, they go to work there on the right. And again, you see how hot the car was.
So with this long green flag run, it looks like we have now 8 cars on the lead lap. Mike Duncan, the last car. We have 8 cars, or 9 cars rather, running on the lead lap. Duncan is on there, so is Scott Lynch, Gilliland, and then it is Gaylord Conway in fourth position. Then the 8th car of Borneman. Schrader is running second right behind Clint Bowyer. Working lap number 67 now. Boy, after we had that red flag, this race is flying by, Pat.
It absolutely is. Looks like Boyer's trying to get up under Mike Duncan there off of 4, headed back towards the stripe. And he actually has got Scott Lynch right in front of him as well. So those guys are gonna put a few cars down there. If you look at Ricky Vyers, that's the crew chief for Clint Bowyer, kind of watching his driver, watching what's going on. And Ricky's really had some strong moments. And yellow flag.
Yellow flag is out. Looks like we might have some debris in turn 4. That's the report we're getting from NASCAR. Debris in turn 4. It has brought out the yellow, and boy, was Scott Lynch glad to see that flag come out. Mike Duncan had already gone a lap down, and Lynch was just seconds away from being lapped by Bowyer, and that yellow flag will keep Scott Lynch on the lead lap. We are having some pit stops or some lap cars, and one of the leaders is back in. Johnny Borneman, for the second time, is on pit road, and they're making a major adjustment on that car, Pat.
Well, he's got nothing to lose right now. I mean, as far as being under the caution flag, go in. He's not going to, you know, fall that far back as far as the lead lap goes, and there's not too many cars on the lead lap. So Borneman and everybody else who thinks getting another couple tires is going to make a difference here with, just under 30 laps to go, comes in and makes that stop. So that's probably a good move.
Yeah, you're only allowed 2 tires per stop, so he was able to come in and get 4 tires on during this caution. We'll see if that makes a difference for Borneman, because it was obvious at that point that he didn't really have anything for the leader, Clint Bowyer, and he had been passed by Ken Schrader. Also on that lead lap now, Gilliland and Conway in the 28 machine.
Let's see if we can get a word with Kenny Schrader. Kenny, this is Pat up in the tire, buddy. How about the car after that last pit stop?
Well, we're fighting a little loose off, Pat, but the only shot we had was the yellow to get caught back up to Clint. We were breaking about even our time, so we ought to be able to have some fun here.
And folks, we are ready to go back. Green flag racing, final stages here of the King Taco 200. Green flag is out. Duncan, the lap car on the inside, and boy,
Something happened to Bowyer.
Bowyer all of a sudden got way off the pace.
He is dead stick in the middle of the racetrack, and I don't know, but what he may have just missed a shift. He looks like he's got the car going again, and Clint Bowyer may have just missed a critical restart shift as Kenny Schrader and the rest of the field just rockets by and sticks him halfway in the pack.
Unbelievable. You saw David getting the lap back, or rather Mike Duncan getting his lap back. And Ken Schrader taking over the lead in the 99, finished second in this race 1 year ago.
Well, Mike Duncan actually is still a lap down because he's behind the leader, Kenny Schrader, right now. So he hadn't gotten his lap back. But what a huge break for Schrader and for David Gilliland, who just got handed a present there with Bowyer and the problem that he had on the race car.
Gilliland has run well today, but really hasn't had anything all day for Schrader or Bowyer. And let's take a look, Pat, at that restart again. Keep your eye on the 20 car of Clint Bowyer, who just all of a sudden, you're right, it was just dead in the water in the middle of your screen.
Yeah, he just either had a clutch problem or just totally missed the shift, one or the other, because Schrader just about had to, just
watch
about
Schrader's
ran over.
Watch Schrader's move right here. There it is, and Schrader makes a great move, goes up on the high side of the racetrack, and is able to get by.
You know, the other thing that might have happened, too, was he might have had it in gear, and it jumped out of gear, or popped out of gear, because it looked like he accelerated on the get-go there when the flag came out. But then perhaps what happened was is that sometimes, you know, these transmissions can pop out of gear if he's got a problem. That may be what happened to Clint Bowyer. Certainly be interesting to find that out from his crew chief. You know, maybe if Candace can find that out for us, that would be great.
Yeah, we'll see if Candace Krueger can find out what the heck happened with Clint Bowyer on that restart. Take a look at it from Ken Schrader, and watch the move that Schrader has to make going up to the high side of the racetrack.
See, the car takes off. If you watch Boyer's car, it took off right there when he got the green flag. But now look, see, it faded back. So one of two things happened. Either it jumped out of gear or had a clutch problem right there, but that all of a sudden now he got it back in gear and he's back up to speed again now.
But is there enough time?
Got a lot of work to do if he wants to get back to the front. A lot of cars to pass out here, and it's not an easy job.
Bowyer now being posted as the last car on the lead lap in the seventh position. So to line it up for you, it is Ken Schrader who leads the race now, David Gilliland second, and Scott Lynch, who has come from starting at the rear of the field up to third place.
We'll talk about that restart again. Brendan Gaughan was just standing here, former champion in the series. We were talking about why you don't get right up on the back of somebody in a restart, because that's exactly what can happen to you. Car jumps out of gear, something like that on a super speedway. You don't look like you're going that fast when you get the restart, but man, you are really hauling the mail, and right there would have been a perfect indication. If somebody had been right up on the back of Bowyer, they could have very easily ended their own day.
Yeah, Brendan told us it on a restart, getting into somebody really hurt him in a recent race. There is Ken Schrader out of Fenton, Missouri. We'll have more of the King Taco 200 from the California Speedway in a moment.
You know, we talked about the fact the fastest car doesn't always win these races. In fact, on these, particularly here at California Speedway, we've seen a lot of times where, you know, you'll have a car that maybe isn't the fastest, but is in the right place at the right time at the end of one of these races to win it. And Schrader right now, that restart was so key for him to get out in front of Bowyer, and that certainly is going to be the storyline of this race.
His lead just about a second and a half over Johnny Borneman, Schrader over Borneman, and then it is Gilliland and Bowyer now back in fourth place. But, you know, when Ken Schrader gets a lead late in a race, that car is awfully wide. It's awful tough to get by him.
Now, right now, he doesn't have any problems from that perspective. As we got about 13, 12 laps to go as the leader comes by the stripe this time. You know, Schrader's on cruise control right now. Just keep hitting your marks. Keep trying to get as much as you possibly can out of the race car, right down to the bottom of the racetrack. Man, that car sticks really nice down there, and that's exactly what you want. And then you hope when you get down in three and four that it's not going to want to push up the speedway on you, shove the nose of it. And, you know, Schrader's he's had a good, consistent car most of the day. They've made good calls and good adjustments.
A win today for Ken Schrader would be his ninth in this West Series. He also won at Phoenix this season. He's won this race twice, back in 97 and 98, and has again finished second here 1 year ago. To a guy we haven't talked a lot about today, Steve Portengay, who is on the pit box and calling the shots for Tim Woods.
Yeah, Timmy Woods, again, wanted to get in here and get some experience. Portengay has won here before, and He and I are old teammates back from the Southwest Tour days and won a couple championships there. Schrader's got to work some lap traffic there. He's got to get around Sean Woodside, and this is another factor in the race. You can't get held up out there because Clint Bowyer does have a horse he can ride as we get down to about 10 to go.
10 to go here at the California Speedway. We've only had a couple of caution flags today. It's been a pretty clean race.
Woodside moves up, gives Schrader some racing room down there on the bottom. That was good of him to do that. And he's going to have the same situation here with a number of lap cars as he begins to catch them in the closing stages.
And those lap cars giving him plenty of room. Seven cars on the lead lap. We were talking about Tim Woods a moment ago. He's four laps down, running 21st position. And you wonder what Johnny Borneman has. Is doesn't seem to be gaining a whole lot. There is, looks like there's trouble. Caution is out.
Caution
trouble
on the
speedway. Trouble in turn four. And that is Eshelman. The 11 car of David Eshelman has spun.
Former mayor of Fontana.
So Eshelman has brought out a caution. And we may have a real shootout here in the West coming up.
Well, this is really what Ken Schrader did not want to see happen. I can tell you that right now. Schrader is now going to have to let everybody catch back up. And guess what? We got a brand new ball game.
David Eshelman's spin has brought out the caution. It'll be a shootout between Schrader, Borneman, and Boyer. Under 10 laps remain. The yellow is out here in the King Taco 200. And as Pat Patterson told you a moment ago, that is not what Ken Schrader wanted to see. He had been dominant here in the early stages after Clint Bowyer looked like he missed a shift or something on a restart.
Yeah, this is not the situation Kenny wanted to have because, again, Bowyer, you know, had the problem on the restart, which, of course, breeds the next question.
Now, here comes something else. Bowyer had been pretty good on restarts. He has a fast car.
Yeah.
Pretty powerful. He is going to be now catching up to Borneman and Schrader and starting third. So he may be a factor here in these final laps.
Johnny Borneman, this is Pat Patterson up in the tower. Looks like you got a shot at this one, man. How's your car?
We just pulled a guy. The shifter's stuck in third gear. It's stuck in gear, so we had a good shot. We're definitely going to win this thing today, but it's my luck. I can never catch a break. So thanks, guys, for being with me all day.
All right. Well, he is as he just said, having a problem with the clutch
break.
And stuff in second gear. So this restart is obviously not going to be an opportunity for him. But he is going to give Kenny Schrader an opportunity to keep him between him and Clint Bowyer. And that's going to be key here for Schrader. At least he's got one other car that he's going to deal with before he can get to Schrader.
So now Bowyer becomes the key player here, if you will, to try to catch Ken Schrader, as you heard, the tough break for Johnny Borneman. With the car stuck in third gear, and he's had problems with his clutch all day, and shifter's broken, and he's going to be stopping on the racetrack now as you see the eight car slowing, letting everybody by. So what a break now for Bowyer and the opposite position from the last
restart.
That's
a class act right there. He's given these guys a chance to race for it. He didn't want to be a factor in the end of this because of a mechanical problem, so he pulls down there, and that's going to give these two guys up front a chance to race for the win.
So they're showing the one to go. This will be the third time they've done it, but the quickie yellows have come out each time as they find that debris still out there.
Well, let's try one more time, see if we get a quick word with Kenny Schrader real quick. Kenny, is this the fun part?
I don't know, Pat. I'd rather have a half straightaway lead and have four to go, but yeah, it ought to be fun. You know, I've got a good kid behind me, and it'll be fun.
Yeah, that may be terminal with those guys. I don't know that they're going to get it restarted now.
What a job that is.
That's a tough
deal. You
talk
about athletes. Look at the guys in the back of that car.
Yeah, they're pushing for all they're worth right now, but I don't know that they're going to be able to get it going. We'll see if it'll refire for him.
Well, give that crew an A for effort.
Got it going.
How about that? And you know what? He's still going to be on the lead lap.
Too little, too late, though, Mike. Looks like we're going to come back to a green flag this time, and I think the 20 and Schrader are going to have to really settle it amongst themselves up there. Scott Gaylord's right there. If anything happens here, he could be a player here as well.
Well, the pace car should pull down on pit road this time. We've got five laps to go. Ken Schrader, the veteran, out of Fenton, Missouri, will lead the field on this single-file restart. Green is out. And a good jump for Schrader.
Clint Boyer was a little further back than I would have thought that he wanted to be. We talked about a comfortable margin, but that was a little too comfortable, I think.
Boy, and what a jump again for Ken Schrader. He has pulled now some 6-7 car lengths out in front of Boyer. Gaylord third. You know, he may get that half straightaway lead before this is all said and done. Well, that made him comfortable.
You know, again, I wonder if Clint Boyer's having any problems transmission-wise or whatever, because I just didn't expect him to be that far back on that restart. And right now, Schrader looks really good as we get down to just three or so laps left.
Clint Boyer started on the pole. Ken Schrader, the eighth fastest qualifier. Boyer out of Emporia, Kansas. Schrader out of Missouri. A couple of guys from the Midwest have come out to the West.
It's a battle for fourth right there between Kevin Conway and Scott Lynch.
Conway's done a great job today. And Lynch, of course, the defending series champion, ninth in the points.
About to catch Scott Gaylord, too, there. I wonder if Gaylord's having some kind of a problem. As you watch the back up front, should be two to go as we watch Schrader come back to the line.
Closing stages of the race. And I think all these guys, even the ones that came here with no experience, have done a great job of running this racetrack today.
Scott Gaylord just gave up the third spot there.
Schrader and Boyer,
actually, Gaylord
though,
is still in the third spot. Kevin Conway running fourth on the racetrack.
Schrader and Boyer, though, hanging at one and two as we're about to see the white flag here at the California Speedway. Can Ken Schrader hold on? White flag is out. Final lap.
And it's not over yet. Clint Boyer's gaining some real ground here. We may have a battle for this one before it's over with.
Around this racetrack for the final time. If you've got anything, you got to show it right
now. Man, Schrader went way down to the bottom of the racetrack on that lap. I mean, he was down below the white line in one and two, as Boyer was a little bit further outside of that, and he really got through one and two big.
And that may have won him the race. As they head into three and four, it doesn't look like Boyer is going to be able to catch him.
Off the fourth corner.
Checkered flag is out. Ken Schrader making the run for the checkered flag. And Schrader, the veteran driver, has won here in the West Series at the California Speedway for the third time in his career. Boyer comes home second. Scott Lynch overcame all kinds of troubles today to finish third.
And I tell you, you got to hand it to Kenny Schrader. He just he did what he needed to do all day long, kept his car in position. They made good calls, good adjustments. Donnie Richardson making a good call there, and Schrader with a big win. We'll see if we can get a word with him right now. Kenny, looks like you had a great day out there, buddy.
As we fastest dog didn't win today, but let's thank Federated Auto Parts for hanging in there with us. We had a new sponsor on here, Pat. It's a good way to start, AXA Financial Service. So we did good pit stuff and got a break there, you know, when Clint had some problems. But, hey, we'll take it, buddy.
Well, congratulations to you, man. Go celebrate with you guys.
Ken Schrader crawling out of his race car, and Candace Krueger is down there in Victory Lane. Candace?
We welcome to Victory Lane Mr. Ken Schrader, the only third man in the third time, the only man to win three times this race in the West Series. Congratulations.
We're probably luckiest to where we ever were this time. Clint was doing a real good job, and the 8 car was running good, but Clint had some problems getting in gear and restart there, and that just gave us enough of an opportunity.
really a tough race all the way until the end. At one point, did you know you had it won?
At lap 20, I was thinking, oh, man, is this going to be a long day? But it got looking better later.
Well, congratulations to you. You obviously know what it knows what it you always obviously know what it takes to get the job done here, having won three times. Congratulations.
Thank you much.
Well, no question about it. Kenny does know how to get it done. We talked about it earlier, and he's the consummate racer, man. He'll be in a race car every chance he gets.
Here's the way they finished. We talked about Clint Bowyer and Scott Lynch overcoming that motor problem earlier in the week. Scott Gaylord, a good run today, and you really liked Kevin Conway and his efforts with the top five.
Yeah, Kevin, a good solid run. That's what they wanted to get done. David Gillen, I know he's not going to be happy after this one because I think he felt like he had a little bit better car than he did. Maybe taking those tires at the end wasn't such a good idea unless he thought he had one going down. Brett Thompson, Mike Duncan, Mike David, and how about Jose Luis Ramirez with a good solid top 10 finish here today for those guys. That was a good run for him.
Yeah, out of Mexico City, Eric Norris. Not the race that he wanted. Austin Cameron went down two laps. He had some real problems early today. And Jason Jefferson's first time on this track finishes three laps down.
Yeah, Tim Woods, just look at some of the guys back in the back that probably didn't get the run they wanted here today. But, you know, coming here and getting experience for a lot of these guys is so very, very important. And I think everybody who finished this race with a race car that was in one piece and so forth is going to be happy that they got that experience.
And you talked about the tough day and tough restart for Clint Bowyer, but still coming home with a second-place finish. He's with Candace.
Thanks, Mike. Clint, tough times out there. You had some transmission problems. Talk to us about that.
Well, the gear shift knob fell off for one, but now ever since we got here, I knew there was something wrong with that transmission, and we just didn't have another one, or it's a shame. It won't go into gear regular.
Yeah, I spoke to Rick during the race, and he said that you had problems with that transmission all weekend. That's got to be tough.
Yeah, they tried to switch handles on it for me to a shorter one so it'd, you know, help it, but all in all, I'm happy for those guys. Had a good run in that 20 car. I want to thank Bill McAnally and Napa for putting me in it, and just enjoy myself out here, and we'll get that old boy someday.
That's right. You've got to be pleased to come in second and pick up a lot of points.
Oh, absolutely. It was a good run.
Okay, thanks, Clint. Congratulations.
He called Schrader an old boy.
Yeah,
he didn't say that, did he?
Yeah, he did. I will tell you what, though. The old boy showed him a trick or two today, and Bill McAnally's got to be awfully proud of Clint Bowyer, and that, of course, the team car to Austin Cameron, and Bowyer steps in and does a great job. Second time that he's run that car this year. Now the let's go and find the third place finisher. There is Scott Lynch, and there's Candace right with him.
To be thrilled when I spoke to you yesterday, you were a little concerned going in on a new engine.
Oh, a little bit. You know, you never know what can happen, but Kevin Kroyer builds us a great motor every single race, and I can't do this without Yurf Dog and Mr. Gong, and I mean, this Yurf Dog team is just awesome, and with Dodge helping us out every race, we should be good to go for the rest of the season.
And having to start out at the back, too, it was just a lot of fun watching you move up to the top.
Oh, it was awesome. It was a lot of work, though, but we played it smart. We had to keep coming in and tuning on the car. It wasn't right perfect, but right there at the end, if we could have had another 10 laps to go, we might have could at least hang with the leaders there. But, I mean, completely awesome. And I want to dedicate this to Pat Tillman. He was a family friend of ours, and we want to wish them the best.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
All right. Thanks, guys.
All right, Candace, thanks very much, Mike. A lot of fun, buddy. Glad to be here with you. And, a great race here at Fontana.
Pat, I had a great time here today, and our congratulations to the old boy, Ken Schrader, out of Fenton, Missouri, who won here for the third time, his second win in the series this year. Candace Kruger on the pit road, and Pat Patterson up here in the booth. I'm Mike Hogwood. We'll say so long from the California Speedway, and congratulations to Ken Schrader.